Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our next bout of the evening. Please welcome to the cage and the blue corner, Tim Nabler! And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please welcome to the cage and the red corner, Stephen Buckman.
We're bringing the legs into action with a pro K1 match at super welterweight. I'll be contested over three 3-minute rounds. Stephen Buckmeyer from Sabai Muay Thai versus Tim Niblett from Falcon Martial Arts. I was in that ride, that's numerous times to the back of it. Like a DJ scratched that in, thinking of a chat for it. And it all sounds good in the net, but live in the streets, what's happening? Jules get done and get done by us, cause don't respect and get done. See how relaxed people are when we hit the professional ranks.
Yeah, it's a noticeable difference. I think that's what you get with experience. Well, oil in the groove, knowing what to expect in the zone. This is what you see in professionals. They're just there. I know it sounds corny, but it's their job. You know what I mean? That's what they do. They do this day in, day out. They're, of course, they're going to be nervous.
Like, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, your next bout of the evening is a pro K1 contest to be fought over 3 3-minute rounds in the super welterweight division. So introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner tonight, making his professional debut, representing Falcon Martial Arts, please welcome Tim Nabler. His opponent standing across the cage, fighting out of the red corner tonight, making his professional debut, representing Sabi Muay Thai, please welcome Stephen Buckman.
Well, look at the eyes on
your
Stephen
referee in
Buckman.
Charge of the action, Carsten Blanchois.
He looks like he means business and he's come to fight.
We've only got to look into Buckman's corner. He's got a really savage pro fighter in his corner and Taz, and you know, if that's who you're training with and that's how you're going to fight, you're going to come to war, basically. Buckmeyer taking centre of the cage immediately, hitting with that switch kick.
Through that left head kick, very fast. And
oh, big left up.
Niblett's hands were low when that kick came in. I think still low.
One thing to consider as well is that Niblett's, the gym he's coming from, they also have a big traditional martial arts background as well. So as you saw with the axe kick, but yeah, that does bring the tendency to drop the hand a little bit. Tends to be the battle of the low kick in this first round so far. Looks to me like Buckmeyer is just a more polished fighter in this opening stanza. He looks a bit more composed.
It's much more balanced when he throws his shots. never a massive fan of axe kicks. I don't feel like they really often have great effect for the amount it off balances you and makes you vulnerable when you're throwing them.
Yeah, I don't think it's a good idea to be throwing them with your back against the cage either. You're going to struggle getting the leverage, bringing the, like trying to contract the hamstring, bring that heel down. Big knee from Buchmeier. I think that's the better approach when you're fighting in a cage. Push your man against the, against where he can't lean out. There's no ropes to lean out, and then coming big with the knees, big heavy shots with the knees.
I think referee just having a quick chat because he held with both his hands when he threw that knee in almost like a tie clinch, which in K1 you're supposed to not hold on and do it. Just throw the knee from the outside, you're fine. Yeah, nicely making him miss and punishing him with a hard leg kick.
Maybe it's liking that inside low kick to the front thigh of Buchmeier. Well checked then. I don't know if he'll be throwing any more of those.
Niblet's hands are scaring me here.
I think Buchmeier's going to be looking to exploit those low hands in a second. He's looking set up a switch kick of some kind.
That is not a good idea.
He's going to get warned again for clinching.
Yeah.
Now, this is a professional K1 fight. It's not a Muay Thai fight, so you cannot clinch with both hands and knees. One hand only, and then you've got to disengage. Now, Niblet might be enjoying this short rest to get his composure back. I'd like to see him bringing his hands up a little bit more, though.
And especially not trying to take shots on his face, but just moving like that. Very dangerous.
There's that switch kick.
It's great being tough and being able to take a shot, but you shouldn't have to.
I can see Buchmeier going to try and come over the front shoulder of Niblet with his hands that low. Being the taller fighter, Buchmeier, it's going to make more sense for him to come up for that head kick, especially if he's getting his opponent circling towards that power side.
I wondered if that's what Buchmeier was doing was with his repeated leg shots, was trying to lead that false sense of security, go to the leg, go to the leg, go to the leg, and then when he's not expecting it, go to the head. But it just never came.
yeah, I believe so. Because when you look at him throwing these low kicks, he's not turning his hip all the way in to smash the leg. It's more of a...
Feels like it's a setup shot as opposed to a... Yeah.
It's a lot faster. But I think Niblet's going to have to start doing something in this round, though, because Buchmeier's started to run away with it in that last minute. And I know Niblet's obviously tough, but he's not scoring, really. He's throwing a few leg kicks in, but this is not Muay Thai. This is K1, and the punches score just as highly as the kicks. And it's Buchmeier we see with a solid all-round approach.
And ultimately, it's work rate and its shots landed. It's a much more simple way of scoring. You can't afford to sit back. It's got to be pressing the action, coming forwards.
Well, that's what makes fighters like Rogtang so successful. They just shot after shot after shot after shot after shot. These are short rounds. We've literally not got time to be sitting back. You've got to push the pace in K1. That's what the rule setter is designed for. Yeah, but he loves that front kick.
Yeah, so I'm a big fan of the front kick, to be fair. And when it's landed well, it can have good effect. But he's eating a lot of leather there. But the only thing is, he's not following up with anything on it. He's landing the push kick, and then nothing happens afterwards.
Yeah, it pushes Buchmeier away, but he can come back in. He can come back in, and that's the problem. If you're going to use that push kick, you've got to follow it up with something. You're either going to follow it with movement or an attack.
Buckmeyer's balance and control is so much better. It's much more grounded. He's walking forwards through every shot. That was a nice knee.
Lovely.
That's
knee
much
again.
Better work from Buchmeier.
Great jab, snapping the head back there.
I don't feel like there's any sting in these kicks from Niblet there.
Well, I think the difference is in the hip. We're seeing Buchmeier turn that hip over, whereas I think Niblet's just coming up with the leg to try and keep his man off him. There he is with the inside low kick again.
Nice push kick there. That lead leg is damaged there, and I think Buchmeier can see it, and he's eliminating that axe kick for a start. I think simple jab, low kick, and you can stop his man.
Yeah, I think that's it. Especially when you fight, if your fighter starts coming back with the same move, you know yours is working. That's it. When the knee starts caving in, it's a bit hard to check now.
Yeah.
But his legs going to be full of blood. It's going to be heavy.
It's too late. He's done the damage. Look.
Yeah. I think we're going to have a stoppage here in a minute.
Yeah. He's not even blocking them now, though. That's the problem. Buckmeyer has seen it. He should go back to the leg. Go there, but go back to the leg.
Well, he's not intelligently defending himself, so the referee is going to give him an 8 count. You must intelligently defend yourself. That's what you need to remember. The referee's in there for the fighter's safety first and foremost. And the number one rule is intelligently defend yourself.
I feel like sometimes someone being a really, like, he's obviously a tough lad, he's got a granite chin on him, but sometimes that can be a strength and sometimes it can be a weakness. And right now, I think for him, it's a weakness.
Yeah, well, as we've just seen there, he relied on his chin. But what he was out of position, so he's like, oh, my chin's fine, I can take this shot. You can't always take it if your feet aren't planted on the floor, if you're not in your base. And that's what we see there. So that's 2 knockdowns in a round. 1 more knockdown, the fight's over.
Look at him trying to walk on that left leg.
Yeah, I can see a jab low kick again. That's where we should be going. I know it's tempting to go for the knockout up high, but the leg is there. It's ready.
Oi! Great head kick. Massive left hook landed there, and the referee saw
that.
That'll
be all she wrote, yeah. Again, we're not intelligently defending yourself, but that's not taken away from Buckmeyer's relentless pace. It's shot after shot after shot after shot after shot.
Solid as well.
You feel like you're drowning when you're fighting somebody like that, because you can fire back, but if you're having a break and they're not, they're piling up. It's piling on top of you. You're accumulating damage and you're accumulating fatigue. Now, brilliant outing for a debut as a professional. I'm excited to see this guy fight again.
Yep, me too.
Fight us to center, please. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, please show your appreciation for both fighters this evening. But ladies and gentlemen, the time of 2 minutes, 55 seconds of the second round. Your referee stops the contest. Your winner by TKO in the red corner, Steven!